Now, last week, Apple enabled the ECG feature on their Apple Watch Series 4, and it looks like it's already helped one person identify a condition that could have led to some significant health issues. This user on Reddit by the name of eDental posted he's heading to a cardiologist because after they activated that feature on his watch, he ran the test and it said he was in AFib. He ran it again and it said, again, you're in AFib. He gave the watch to his wife and had her run it. Her heart rhythm was fine, so he decided that maybe I gotta go get this checked out. So he printed out his atrial fibrillation recommendation from his watch. Remember in our video, you can produce a PDF of what it read. And sure enough, he had a very rapid heart rate for being in a resting state. You can see very rapid beats here, and then a pause, some more rapid beats, and another pause, a big pause here. This is not a normal heart rhythm, so he decided to go to the emergency room. He was kind of embarrassed at first, as he mentioned here in his post. He said, you know, my watch is a new feature. What do you think? And they just let him right in. When you got a heart condition at the ER, they just don't make you wait online for that. So they brought him in. We went from having this relatively low detailed thing to getting the proper ECG taken on a proper medical device. And here you can see his heart rhythm is at 132 beats per minute, which is wicked fast. And you can also see the level of detail that you get from a true ECG machine. But nonetheless, this low detailed report was enough to get this guy into some treatment. And hopefully his cardiologist now, who's armed with much more detailed information, can get him on the right track and have this condition treated. It's a very treatable condition. It's something that you can live with. And I'm glad that the watch was able to help him get there. This feature, though, is not enabled in most countries. They did activate it in the US last week. The US regulators determined that there is greater benefit than risk in having this feature enabled and making some medical recommendations for people. In some of the testing that they did with the feature while it was being developed, they were in the high 90 percentile compared to a regular ECG for detecting AFib. But it's possible that it might miss a diagnosis or something like that. But again, the benefits here far outweigh the risk, especially for this guy who had this condition, didn't know he needed to check for it, but checked solely because it was a new sensor feature they enabled on his watch. So I'm glad that they got that going. And I hope many other countries around the world start allowing this as well, because I do think it will end up saving lives and preventing some serious health issues.
This channel is brought to you by the Lon.TV supporters, including gold-level supporters Chris Allegretta, the Four Guys with Quarters podcast, Tom Albrecht, Gerard Newberg, and Kalyan Kumar. If you want to help the channel, you can by contributing as little as a dollar a month. Head over to lon.tv/support to learn more. And don't forget to subscribe. Visit lon.tv/s.